W8MI, W8MI, Whiskey 8, Mexico, India. Dennis, do you read me? Can I just text you next time? This is weird. Can you read me, D-News? What's your 20? Scienceman Trace here, hamming it up for D-News. Remember that time 11 needed to talk to Will in the Upside Down? The kids were excited because they got to use a ham radio. Ham radio is an amateur radio broadcasting system. People who operate ham radios are called hams. There are nearly 3 million ham licenses worldwide, with major populations of hams in Japan, Germany, England, Indonesia, South Korea. According to the National Association for Amateur Radio, there are more than 727,000 licensed ham radio operators in the United States, making us the second largest community. I say community because that's what amateur radio operators are all about. Ham radios are exactly like any other radio, but instead of your local rock, country, or Beyonce station playing nothing but the hits, nothing but the hits. Instead, it's Jenny from the block, like literally down the block, Sloan from Canada, or Siso from Swaziland, right there in your radio. Aside from the fun community aspects in times of disaster, when cell towers and internet is down, hams can still communicate with each other and with emergency services. All radio works the same, even amateur ham radio. When electricity travels through an antenna of some kind, another antenna can pick it up and decode it. Tune a radio to a static AM station. Grab a 9-volt battery and a coin. Hold them near the antenna and connect the coin to the studs of the battery. The radio will pick something up. The electricity is broadcasting on the radio band. The battery will only go a few inches, but with more power, the signal would go farther. Thanks to advances in technology, we can pinpoint exact frequencies to broadcast on, where the radio waves are precisely tuned so they don't interfere with each other. According to How Stuff Works, ham bands are, quote, above the AM band to just above the citizens band, also known as CB radio. And on those ham bands, the FCC says people can send 1,300 different types of communication using voice, video, digital, telegraphy, or Morse code, you name it. It's all shared space, though, so if someone else is using that frequency, it just becomes a party line. There are three main ham radio bands, HF, VHF, and UHF. With UHF, or ultra-high frequency, the waves leave the antenna and bounce off buildings and around solid things, but they don't go around mountains. VHF, or very high frequency waves, can pass around some obstacles, but still can be blocked. These are mainly line of sight antennas. Think FM radio, which is why it doesn't work over the curve of the Earth or behind a mountain. But that doesn't stop all radio. HF, high frequency waves, are my favorite when you talk about it in this way. Because starting about 50 kilometers above you is the ionosphere, an electrically charged layer of the atmosphere. Ham radios using the HF range can bounce those waves off the ionosphere, creating a sky wave. That wave skips to another point on the Earth, or hits another antenna, which can rebroadcast it. All ham signals can be rebroadcast. Someone could pick it up and send it out again, like a relay. I wasn't kidding when I said you could pick up Siso in Swaziland. But Swaziland isn't the furthest that radio can reach. In 1969, an operator in Louisville, Kentucky, picked up radio between Armstrong and Aldrin on the moon during Apollo 11. He even recorded President Nixon's message to them. You can still talk to astronauts with amateur ham radio today. The ionosphere doesn't bounce all signals. On the International Space Station, the crew has access to a ham radio. When they are overhead, their 2-meter FM transceiver allows the ground to have a chat with space. You can see for yourself that the astronauts are overhead, talk to them while they're there, and then they'll fly away. Take that, conspiracy theorists. It's pretty exciting that we can do all this with waves of electromagnetic energy. The more you think about it, the cooler it gets, which is why we did a whole DNews Plus on light. What is DNews Plus? You don't know? You know what that is? It's like DNews, but 10 times longer. We take a big topic like artificial intelligence, leaving Earth, or light, and get nerdy with it. If you're smelling what we're cooking, subscribe to DNews Plus on YouTube or listen to it as an audio podcast on SoundCloud or iTunes. Because of wave-particle or particle-wave duality, light is considered both because it's a photon propagating through space as an electromagnetic wave. Now, this sounds complicated, but if you're following me so far, great, because we're about to go crazy. Have you ever tried to learn ham radio? Let us know in the comments, and if you have a call or a handle or whatever they call it, let us know. Thanks for watching.